are the mind control freaks. Four master manipulators, each with their own method of controlling other people.
Asleep.
Anyone help? Hello?
You're aware of the risks.
You might think you're in charge of your own actions. The mind control freaks will make you think again.
Amazing.
No, it ain't right.
I'm totally baffled.
Welcome to the show. Are you ready to have your mind well and truly warped? This is what will be doing the damage. Today, Lewis is at pains to work his voodoo magic.
Just imagine that this doll is you.
Alex takes some savvy New Yorkers for a ride.
So I'm the first one to get this?
Yeah. You're the lucky one. What can I tell you?
I just gave away a $20,000 car to a stranger.
And Pete makes it crystal clear that you should never trust him with your cell phone.
Picture your phone in your mind. That's about you believing that you can find your phone with a crystal.
That one.
I'm in the East End of London, looking for someone to help me explore the idea of voodoo. By controlling their mind, I can make someone feel pain without laying a single finger on them. Watch and find out.
Adam.
Hey.
I want to try an experiment with you. It's going to be a little bit strange, but do you think you could take a little bit of pain?
I think so, yeah.
What I have here is an electrostimulation device. Essentially, it's a machine that will deliver an electric shock through your body. I'm going to attach these on your lower back, so if you can just lift up the back of your shirt.
Okay.
And this goes here. Also, Adam, I have here the remote for this device. When I press the button on it, you're going to receive an electric shock. Describe what that felt like.
It's really sharp.
And like, really sharp, yeah.
Could have been smacked with something really hard.
But now here's where things get interesting, you see. That's a physical pain. That's real electricity going through your body, and it is physically painful. It's real. But now I want to try something a little bit stranger. Adam, do you know what this is?
It's like a voodoo doll.
It is a voodoo doll. Now, what I want you to do is just imagine that this doll is you. And everything that happens to this doll will happen to you. You will feel the pain, but it will not harm you in any way. Just concentrate on the doll. One more time. So you've had imaginary pain and real pain. Which was worse?
Imaginary pain.
The imaginary pain.
Sounds a bit bizarre, but...
So you prefer the real physical pain over the imaginary pain?
Any day, yeah.
Any day.
I'll take that. I'll take the physical pain.
Really? Well then, here it is.
So how could I get Adam to feel the pain of a needle that never actually touched him? Well, we tested several members of the public, and Adam was the most open to suggestion.
Really sharp, intense, in just a concentrated spot in the hand.
I knew I could plant the idea into his subconscious, so that Adam would be able to identify with the doll and create the feeling of pain all by himself. I then got rid of any memory that we'd even met.
It's very shocking. It sounds really silly when you say it's an imaginary pain. It's not when you feel it.
It's not only a mentalist like Lewis who can use the mind to bend the body to its will. Imagine I offered you a choice between these two pills. Which would you choose if you wanted to boost your energy levels? And which would you choose if you had trouble sleeping? What does the red pill do? And what does the blue pill do? In studies, subjects who took the red pill reported feeling more awake, while those who took the blue pill felt drowsy. In reality, both pills are identical and have no effect at all on your energy levels. Only their colors are different. It's a classic example of the placebo effect, where the mind can control what the body is feeling without any physical stimulus being required. Now, are you a sheep among wolves? Do you like to do as you're told? Especially when asked by someone in a uniform. Alex is going to show you just how persuasive wearing the right kind of clothes can be.
Countless experiments have been done to show the power authority figures wield over individuals. Now, I want to show you how you can take the theory from the lab and put it into practice here on the street. Now, we all love our cars, and apart from our homes, they're probably the most expensive thing we'll ever own. So, convincing someone to hand over their keys to a total stranger is going to be a big ask, even for someone as persuasive as me. I'm at a public car park in New York, armed with a paper-thin story and lots of nerve. I'm gonna see how many strangers I can get to hand over their car keys. Wish me luck.
The car lot is rigged with hidden cameras, so no one knows they're being filmed. It's no surprise that when asked to hand over their car keys to a stranger claiming he will park it for them, streetwise New Yorkers will look for another parking lot.
So I'm going to try something else. I'm going to invest myself with power and authority. How am I going to do that? I'm going to use one of these. Now, once I get this on, even the most suspicious people turn to obedient sheep. Hi there. Did you leave it here with me? Because we're just rearranging the car, so I'll just, if you leave the keys, I'll park it for you.
Can you get a ticket?
Do you know what? I'm going to be here all day. We've run out of stubs just now, so I can give you one of these.
No. I'm not leaving my
car. We just ran out of tickets. The boss has gone out to get some more. I'm here all day.
He seems suspicious and reluctant, but will my appearance persuade him it's okay to hand over the keys?
So I'm the first one to get this?
Yeah, you're the lucky one. What can I tell you? I don't have anything else to tell you.
Let me see your ID here. Let me see.
I ain't got no ID on me. Look, my boss is going to be here. He's going to give you a ticket. What else do you want me to do? Look, if you don't want to park it here, you don't want to park it, but I'm going to have to ask you to move it because I'm going to get cars in.
Oh, you're taking a picture now?
Yeah, it's a clever man. Here you go.
Hello.
Look, I'm here all day. You're going to see me here, okay?
It's a little messy, so...
Yeah, do you want a valet for you? No. I'm kidding. It was hard work. Very hard work. New Yorkers are savvy. They're used to having ticket stubs. Right. Let's see if we can go find it now. Here's the keys back. As you guessed, I don't work there.
So I'm the first one to get this?
Yeah. You're the lucky one. What can I tell you? I'll be long gone with your car.
I don't know, it might break down.
I'll sue you for a Lexus.
The real reason why I hand out the keys was because of the vest. I just gave away a $20,000 car to a stranger.
Yeah. I'll park it for you here because we're just moving some cars around.
Okay.
What was amazing about that is he didn't even ask me for a stub or anything. He just handed the keys over and walked off. These are your keys?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. I don't work for that car park.
Okay.
Did you think I did?
Yes.
Why?
Because you were standing over there in front of the parking lot.
Did it?
Where that?
That? This?
Yeah.
How much is your car worth?
Probably like $10,000.
This is worth $13. You just handed me the keys. But if I was to drive it off and you came back, what would you do?
I don't know. Maybe call the cop if I don't see
my. And what would you say?
I gave my car to somebody. The stuff he's wearing definitely convinced me he works there. At the same time, he mentioned something, oh, we got too many cars in there. Let me just grab it, because that's what usually, you know, the valet parking is. The only thing is, I guess I also made a mistake on my side. I didn't get a voucher from him, which I usually do.
I'll park it for you here, because we're just moving some cars around.
Okay. The yellow vest symbolizes he works over there, so he's a trustworthy person. I can trust him to leave my car to him, so.
How long are you gonna be? Okay, I need to park it in for you because we're just moving some more cars around.
Surely, I can't make it three in a row. Can I?
Was ridiculously easy with a vest on now. You just handed me your keys to your car.
Yeah, I did.
Do you think I worked there?
I did.
Why?
The safety vest.
The safety vest.
I'll take these.
Yeah, you take those.
Yeah, I mean, my car's worth 18 to 20,000, so to, you know, lose it from giving a guy with a $13 vest my keys, it's a bit much.
So, where's my car?
It always amazes me how pre-programmed we are to respond to uniforms. These things give you so much power. Not only do the people invest you with power, but myself, when I wear this, I act with authority, I act with power, I feel more in command. They're stunning, stunning things, and very useful as well. I'm gonna keep this one.
You're watching The Mind Control Freaks. Can you move mountains with your imagination? Do you believe you can channel energy into inanimate objects? Pete's going to hustle some punters into gambling their possessions in a mistaken belief in mind over matter.
I've worked the streets and people of London for more years than I care to remember. And in that time, there's been one game that brings the punters back time and time again.
Yep, it's the infamous three-card Monty. I'm going to adapt this classic street hustle by placing a £5 note in one of three envelopes. Now, I want to convince the victim they can win by harnessing the power of a mystical crystal. When in fact, they'll be overcome by a mind-body phenomenon seen when using Ouija boards or dowsing for water. The ideomotor effect.
Hello, mate. No, are you all right? How'd you fancy your chances to win a bit of money?
Yeah,
here we go. My name's Peter.
Nice to meet you. I'm TJ.
I'm Jason. Hello.
Nice to meet you, mate.
I'll be Ariana.
Ariana, you are?
Vicky.
Vicky, Ariana. I'll explain how this works. When you hold a crystal, your energy gets conducted through the chain down into the crystal, and the crystal will react to your energy, okay?
Right, okay.
Here's a £5 note. At the moment, it means nothing to you because it's not yours.
Yeah.
Hold on to it, squeeze it tightly in your hand.
I'm trying to transfer some of that energy to you.
Okay.
All right? That's the whole point of this, is to try and get some of your energy through to the £5 note, okay? So we're going to use three envelopes. All right, if you can just check those two and make sure there's nothing in them. I've got the third one, and what I want to do is I'm going to put the £5 note into there. So if the crystal works for you, you should be able to find the £5 note. If you find the money, you get to keep the money. Shuffle them up, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Let's do these. So just hold it over that one, and I want you to tell me when you think there's significant movement in the crystal. That's not doing much there, because I don't know about you. You tell me when you think you're starting to see that pendulum move. You're going to go for that one?
That one.
Right. Which one are you going to go for?
It's so close between these two.
Do you want to make a call?
That one.
You're going to go for that one? Oh, hey.
That one.
I could visualize it.
Our subjects believe the crystal guided them to the money. In reality, I palmed the £5 note to ensure whatever way they chose, they'd always find the cash.
It literally felt like it was moving on the one that I thought it was.
The crystal isn't vibrating through any mystical force. In fact, the ideomotor effect is coming into play, as each of them is subconsciously producing tiny movements. And that's what's making the crystal move.
To begin with, I was really, really skeptical because I was like, this is really, like, odd. But then it seems like we gained a bit of money and I was like, let's trust the crystal.
But they all want to believe in the crystal so much, they've convinced themselves that it is somehow guiding them.
I've got very, very strong visualization of things. And I could see that in my mind's eye, and that was traveling up the crystal.
Time to put their faith to the test by asking them to do the same thing with a prized personal possession.
Do you have a phone?
I've got a phone, yeah.
Have you? Yeah. We're going to try it with a phone, okay? Try it with a phone, all right? What we've done is, just to show you, I've put a piece of tile in each of those, okay? Just check that. So we're going to do a similar thing in terms of putting things in envelopes and finding it, all right?
I've used the tiles so each of the envelopes look like they could contain the phone.
Picture your phone in your mind, okay? It's about you believing that you can find your phone with a crystal, okay? If you do find your phone, I'm going to give you £200.
Really?
Okay, yes. Have real faith in the crystal, okay? That's what's important, is that you have faith in the crystal. Which one are you going to go for?
Do this one first.
Move across. Right, let's try this one.
It's not that one.
It's not that one, okay. Do you know what?
See, that's doing that thing again. That's doing that, like, shaking.
Right,
£200, like,
have you made your decision?
I'm ready to win some money.
I don't know if I'm going to be stupid.
Well, look,
change it back to that one.
It's working for you.
Right.
Concentrate on the phone.
After the apparent success they had using the crystal to find the £5 note...
You're sure about that, yeah?
Yeah.
They're all keen to place their faith in it guiding them to even bigger winnings.
Which one are you definitely? Are you
through my arm to that one?
You agree? Right, let's do it.
My gut instinct is that one.
All right,
I'm gonna go with that one.
Okay. You're cool. And you're going for that one.
I'm going for that one.
Excellent.
Oh no.
The crystal never gets it wrong.
If that's true, then I should pull their phones out of the chosen envelope. If it isn't, I should produce an unbroken tile.
Oh, what the
Oh, no, man.
No, you're kidding me, right? I literally thought you were going to pull it out of that.
The fact is, you committed, and so...
That was my phone.
Ha ha ha!
I'm really hoping this is like literally part of the trick or whatever it's like.
I think that might be that one actually.
I don't even want to see it, mate.
Did you back it up?
No.
The energy was going through my arms to that one.
It was clearly wrong.
Ashley. There's nothing wrong with your phone.
Fortunately, your phone was in my pocket. But here's the thing.
Oh, no way, man.
Your phone's fine. All of this was just an experiment to try and see if you would put your faith in a £12.50 crystal tied to a bit of chain.
I'm so relieved.
And you know what I mean? Some people run their lives putting their faith in things like this.
I visualised it. I mean, I could see
and,
it.
And this is what happens. Is, you know, people, there's this desire for things to work.
I really did feel like the crystal was working. Looking back on it, I don't know whether I actually did. It's probably just in my head.
So you might think that some of the people we saw today were a little bit gullible. But the belief that inanimate objects hold some kind of power is pretty persistent.
I thought there was a connection between my arm and the crystal.
Oh, no.
When he smashed my phone, I myself, I thought he honestly smashed my phone.
Now, we bought that crystal because we were told that it had special powers that could help you make the right choices in your life.
The fact there's still a market for such things in the modern world is perhaps the biggest hustle of all.
That's everything for now from the mind control freaks. At least, that's what you think.